Good afternoon, everyone. I wanted to talk today a little bit about plasma experiment similarities and the pictures we've seen from Earth-based telescopes during the passing of Comet Siding Spring and the possible electrical interaction with Mars. Since the passing of Comet Siding Spring on October 19th, within a few hundred thousand kilometers of Mars, an Earth-based telescope picked up an anomalous event. It looked like an electrical plasma discharge onto the planet. This is a color-enhanced red, so you can see the hourglass shape along with the periphery X that seems to trail off. And my thought was, if it is actually a plasma event and this is connected to the electrical universe, there should be some similarities that we've replicated on our experimental laboratories here on our own planet. The mass reactor, look how very similar that is to what was just shown in that. It has the hourglass shape with the periphery arms coming off both north and south limb. Cornell University replicated the exact same shape phenomenon in the zeta pinch, otherwise known as Z pinch. Notice the same shape again with Texas A&M and Sandina National Laboratory. These are where the filaments rotate and pinch back on themselves in the magnetic field. Just so you didn't forget what shape you're looking for, here it is, that hourglass. Again, at a slightly different experiment at Cornell University, yielding the same exact shape. When you look at dipolar magnetic plasma fields, you start to see that same shape. Spherical torus yields the same results. The array parameters on properties in rotating plasma fields, depending on the metal of the wire, the shape's the same. It comes with that X coming off the limbs there. A closer in look at the spherical torus from Callum in the UK. I did find a conceptualization of what Birkeland currents are and how they pinch on the filaments during star formation. Now, most persons in academia do agree on at least one thing, that plasma is scalable to any size, galactic size down to the nanometer size. So let's take a look at a galactic example. This is the Triangulum galaxy. Again, you notice that same hourglass X shape. One of the reasons I really wanted to bring this up was the electrical universe. This is just another proving point. Is there free electricity around us? Is there any other way to harvest and consolidate electricity for our own uses on this planet? And the thought process going down the road as our planet increases the population, electrical needs will need to be met. This event on Mars, plasma discharge, is just another indicator that the electric universe is a true idea and needs to be experimented on more, and more money needs to be allotted for our testing laboratories to do exactly what Nikola Tesla did in 1897. Here's a couple of patents for you to look deeper in to see what type of wireless transmission devices that were on the books back then, over 100 years ago. I encourage you to take a deeper look into what I've just shown you. This is just scratching the surface. I'm not a plasma physicist. The real masters of this are Donald Scott, Wallace Thornhill, and David Talbot. You can check out their work at Thunderbolts. I'm going to leave the comment box open so we can continue the conversation. I encourage you to leave a note. Thanks for watching.